Yo, impromptu live stream. How's everyone doing today? We are either going to songwrite together, Sunday night songwrite, or we'll learn some Towns Van Zandt. I want to tackle the entire album, his self-titled album. So I've got about maybe half the album down already, and it'd be cool to just finish it. So we'll see who jumps on. These are always unplanned. My schedule's a little too... You know, I'm always moving makeup lessons, and it's hard to be totally predictable on times. But I'm still... I know it's Sunday, but I'm still going to try and stick to the Monday night as a regular thing, even though I missed it last week. So let's see if anyone files in. And I'll do some blues and E while we wait. You don't want to see my keyboard, do you? You want to see my guitar. Yo, yo, hey, what up, Basil, how's it going, man? A song for, you know what, that's a great idea. We could do that today. First come, first serve. I love when I open my YouTube tab, it throws myself at me. Which version? Aren't there a few? Tell me which version of a song for. We could listen to a few of them together. If I remember how to screen share, present, share screen, yeah, Brave tab, song 4, but I want to do the fun one where it's like me and the screen. Yeah, let's see if this works. A song for it. The studio version, is that the best one? The acoustic blue version of that song. See, that's why I gotta ask. What up, Rise Up? How's it going? I love when I see familiar faces in here. All right, let's see if this works. What does it look like now? Man, there we go. Because now I think you guys will hear what I play.
Of love, please keep me true sane.
Yeah, not my favorite version. This is a studio one, right? That one? That one's strong.
Until I reach home on the morrow.
We could do that one. You guys tell me. That one's finger-picked. Sorry, there's going to be a delay. The acoustic blue one is finger-picked. I think there's one other one floating around here. Now this is like drunken Towns ears, huh? Where it's just like brutal to listen to.
Until I reach home on tomorrow.
Yeah, no, that's too slow and depressing. It'll depress me. Now is this the same one? All right, we got the studio. Let's listen to that first one more time. The song for Towns on acoustic blue version. Yeah, I mean, this is acoustic blue. We could do this one. Should we do this one? There's a riff in the album one after the chorus. I know, but I don't want to just do a riff. Let's do a whole song if we're going to do one. So what's the vote? This acoustic blue one or the studio version? Take a vote. I think I'm always partial to the finger picked, but I'm happy to do whatever. Taking a vote. The 9 people are here. Let's take a vote. How's everyone doing? Beautiful Sunday. I attended Divine Liturgy. That's the Eastern Orthodox. We don't call it Mass. We call it Liturgy. It was beautiful today. Praise the Lord. All right. We got 1 vote. 1-0. Come on. There's 9 eyeballs here. What are you guys doing? Let me know what's going on. Oh, 1-1. Holy cow. What are we going to do? What are we going to do about it? How's this going to get resolved? How do we do a... Come on, ChatGTP. Roll the dice for us. Tell us which one we should do. Who's going to do the tiebreaker? Doing good. Hey, SC. Yeah, yo. I'm good, too. Yeah, praise the Lord. It's a good day. You enjoyed my opening song, by the way. Yeah, I don't know. I was just noodling on an E blues, doing the only few tricks that I know. I guess I have quite a few tricks. Not enough to, like, do a whole set, but let's listen to the studio version again for a second. The live version does have a substantial amount of more views. I don't know what that means. I'm weak and I'm weary of sorrow. Yeah, I mean, he's just strumming the chords. I'm sorry, Brazil, but there's really not too much to do here. He's just banging out the chords. But I'll find that riff for you after the second chorus. Can you timestamp it? And I'll teach you the riff. Otherwise, let's do the finger-picked one. How does that sound? Oh, you want the, like, guitar solo? I mean, we could. All of this world be is this the part you're talking about? Do you want me to tab this out? Oh, you panned your mic. I thought my headphones were broken. You know what? This is annoying. I swear I put it in studio. I don't mean to do that. Panning is annoying. They should both be in the same channel. And I thought I had set that up with my audio here. Let me check. Yeah, it says it should be in stereo mode. So sorry if it's panned. There's nothing I can do about that. Scarlet. Yo. Yeah, I mean, stereo mode. Don't know why it's panned. All right, let's do the finger-picked one. And that is the part. All right, I mean, do you want me to tab it out? What should I do here? I don't really do solos that often. I'm missing one note in there. All of this world be forgotten. All right. This is what I'll do. I got to share a new screen with you guys, but I think I got to make myself significantly smaller. To share the new screen. So let's do that. How's everyone doing, yo? Learning some towns. This'll be good. A little solo. Keep me on my toes. You better learn this frickin' solo, man. If I'm taking the time, Basil, you better learn it. I'm gonna keep changing your name, Brazil. I don't even know what I called you. Look, the acoustic guitar will do fine. Is that it? 4-4. 4-6-7-4. Gonna write in the time. I stink at writing out time. It'd take me way too long to get the actual timing right. And that's a hammer on pull off kind of thing. Rakes there. So what's happening there is just like raking down these sevens really quick. It's like a sweep pick kind of thing. It's hard to hear it. I can't really hear it. I get lost. It gets lost in the mix for me. I'm not really hearing it. It's getting buried. We'll do something like that. Ah, I can't get it. Just end it there. All right, I think we got it. Something like that. That's not bad. I feel okay about that. All right, it's on flat. I'm going to publish this thing. let me label this better. A song for Towns solo. Share. Okay, boom. There you go. That's it for that Blaze song you tabbed on live a week ago. Hey, thank you, Rise Up. I appreciate that, man. I will learn it. The very first time you said my name, it was right. Basil? Is that what I said? Basil. Basil. Basil? Basil. Basil. I don't know what the first time was. Slack the planet. What up, Rhino? How you doing, man? All right, Basil, where's the super chat? Come on, Rise Up gave one, and I didn't even do a song today. Thanks for all of your tutorials, Jackie says. Jackie Instrumental. I learned Tecumseh Valley from you a year ago. I've been really into Fairly Well, Miss Carousel recently. Jackie, that makes me so happy to hear. It's so cool. The love is being spread. How do I stop the screen share? There we go. That's so cool you're learning from my channel. Makes me super happy. And Fairly Well, Miss Carousel is an amazing song. And that's the album I want to tackle. My goal is to do that whole album. I think I've done about half of it. And we'll look at it together in a minute. So I'm not going to post all these on my website. But if you guys go to flat.io, here, I'll put it in the chat. Flat.io. And just follow me on there. Now, you can look at everything for free, I believe. I think they only charge you when you start to save files. Like if you want to save more than 6 songs, I think you have to pay. But flat.io, I'll like publish stuff up there that like doesn't necessarily make a full tutorial. Basil, that's awesome, Mike. Thank you. I'm amazed how you did it just like that. You're welcome. Yeah, dude, I've been playing since I was 10 and I'm almost 40 years old. So it's like 30 years of sitting there learning songs by ear real slowly. And we can talk about that one day too. Yeah, you want to do Fairly Well, Miss Carousel right now? No, I'm kind of excited about that song. Or should we stick with a song four? All right, new vote. A song four or Fairly Well, Miss Carousel? New vote. Is Rhino still in the house? What up, Rhino? We keep missing each other. I can't believe we haven't talked yet. There's so much to talk about. It's a crazy week. I can't even go into it, guys. I had a crazy week. It's still too emotional, though. All is well, though, thank God. But I can't. I'll tell the story of the boy and the magnet next time, maybe. I don't know. I have mixed feelings about sharing my personal life on YouTube. You're playing as magnetic, you son of a... You son of a beach. You son of a beach, SD. I look much younger, that's right. I'm 40 years old, believe it. Well, I'm 39. Look at these pearly whites. Look at them. Look at them, SC. Are these the teeth of a 39-year-old or a 19-year-old? Look at these follicles. Look at this. Look at my eyes. Look how red they are. Does that look like the eye of a young buck? Okay, sorry. I finished learning Pancho and Lefty from your website a few weeks ago, working on How Lucky, but might have to pause to learn the solo you just made. That's so cool. I love that everyone's learning from the channel and engaged and is cool. All right, come on. New vote, though. What are we doing? Should I stick with a song for? Or should we jump over to Fairly Well, Miss Carousel? Come on, I'm the dancing monkey. You guys tell me what to do, all right? All right, so I published that one. All right, come on. You guys got like 3 more seconds or I'm just doing it. All right, a song four is still the winner. The acoustic version or the finger-picked version. All right, so I'm going to share the flat doc or do you guys want to see more of me? I don't really know how to fit. Maybe I can put both on equal footing and you guys tell me if it's too small and if I should change it. Because I'm not the one looking at it, right? I'm going to be working. All right? So you guys tell me what view. If that's going to be way too small to see the tab. Probably. I have slight indigestion right now. I ate out. I never eat out, but my in-laws got me a burger, and I had like 2 bites of a coleslaw that had onion in it, and now I'm going to have problems all night. I can't do onion. Now I'm getting real personal in here. Oh, in proper town's fashion, let's hear a joke first. Okay. Are you ready for this one? And I'll even make it. I think I told this one in one of the videos, but it's so good. Do you guys know my Pancho and Lefty joke? So there was these two outlaws, Pancho and Lefty. No, you know what? I'll save that one for later. But I do have a joke. This guy pulls up into a gas station. And it must be in Oregon because there's a gas station clerk there. And this guy pulls up. He starts filling his car up with gas. And the clerk notices that there's a penguin in the back of the guy's car. And so he goes, I gotta find out what the heck's going on here. So he goes up to the guy and he says, "Excuse me, sir. There's a penguin in the back of your car." And that guy goes, "Yeah, I know." And he goes, "Well, you should probably take it to the zoo." The guy goes, "The zoo. The zoo. Yeah, man. Yeah, the zoo." Fills up his gas. He drives off. And then some time passes, you know, maybe it's like a week later. The same car pulls up and the gas attendant's like, "You got to be kidding me." And he looks, and in the back seat is the same penguin, but now the penguin's wearing, it has sunglasses on. And so the clerk's like, "This is unbelievable. What's going on?" He tells his buddies, you know, and he's got to go talk to this guy again. So he goes up to him and says, "Excuse me, sir. The penguin. I thought I told you to take the penguin to the zoo." And the guy goes, "Yeah, it was you who told us to go. We had a great time. And today we're going to the beach." I need a laugh button. Yeah, it's weird telling a joke to nobody. It's a good joke, though. It's a great joke. All right. I got to get better at sharing this. This is way too slow. All right. Here we go. A song four. Let's start. I'll walk you through it. Boom. 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 So that lowest note, boom, is a B. Am I even in tune? And it's minor. So I'm going to guess capo on the second fret. That would be my guess. Because then that B becomes an open string. Oh, hunt for the red October. Hunt for the lost capo. Give me a moment, ladies and gentlemen. Here, I know what I can do while you're waiting. Actually, I don't know what to do. Face blue, smiling. It's a good joke, because people are laughing, right? Hey, all right, I got some laughs. There's some laughs in the house here. I need a capo. If you guys don't have a capo, grab a capo. Capo 2 is my guess. Give me a minute. You know what I can put on? Let's put on a Mike Malaro original. How do I do this, though? Boom, go rain, burn, rain, hurt.
Your soul diminished down to an ancient poem.
as is like nothing else. Yeah, you guys should all stream Malaro for Illinois. I put out a couple records under that name. On your favorite streaming thervative. Your favorite streaming thervative available. All right, capo 2, let's see if I'm right. Could be wrong. Yeah, that sounds right. Too bad we don't get the full intro here. I'm just going to assume those top two A minors are the same both times. And it's in 3-4, right? 1-2 and 3 and boom. So he's hitting that one open. The A minor. Boom. So I didn't put capo 2, because if I put capo on the second fret, what happens is it changes all the notes, and then the few people who do choose to sight read are totally thrown off, because no one thinks to sight read with a capo on. So it's going to sound a little different on the playback, but it's only because it's not capoed. And it goes to a D minor. Guys, again, let me know if this screen share is like an appropriate size, or if this tab is just too teeny tiny. This later town stuff, man, he just kind of loses it picking. It's just not nearly as awesome as when he was in his prime. Just fell apart. Same as the beginning. And then he starts singing, so that's your intro. Let's check in with the chat. How's the chat doing? Kind of small, I can barely read it. Yeah. Quentin, thanks so much for your tutorials from the UK. Been hard at work at Sligo River Blues by John Fahey. Dude, that's a great one. Good luck with it. The muscle memory will come. I know it's mesmerizing. It's like a pattern of 3/2 and it's super confusing. But just go tediously slow, even if you're just getting one measure of that, like, that triplet part at a time. And that'll be cool. Thanks for stopping in, Quentin. Ain't it kind of late over there? There's been a couple people in England who asked about, like, the Zoom meetings and these live streams because it's too late. And for, like, you know, 2 years, I've been like, oh, maybe I'll do an earlier Zoom time. So let me know if you're interested. You can Zoom chat. All right, let me change the... is that better? And I can publish this too. I'll publish it right now. So if you guys go over to flat.io, the song Four Towns Van Zandt, or you can find me on there, Mike's Music Method, and just search through my stuff. There we go. Cool. Let's keep going.
Ribbons of love, please keep me true sane.
Yep, still A minor, D minor, A minor.
Until I reach home.
Well, that changes, though.
Ribbons of love, please keep me true sane.
Yeah, it's real hard to hear what's going on in the recording. But, we'll get close. I almost need to put headphones on, but I don't want to do that right now. Is the start of a verse. I get lost if I don't have my little notes in here.
Until I reach home.
I'm doing thumb, thumb, thumb. 1, 2, 3. My thumb's on 1 and 3. This is back to the D minor. Goes to an F.
Until I reach home on tomorrow.
And he just trails off. Like, it's like his fingers don't work. I don't know what he's playing. He's too drunk. He doesn't know what he's playing either. We'll just do the same descending pattern as last time. Oh, that's not right. And every time I'm doing, again, thumb is on the first beat and the third beat almost every time, so that could be worth putting in there, just to, like, annotate the thing. So P. Fingers are dealing with the rest of it.
Until I reach home.
And then he just ends on the A minor again. Boom, ding, 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 ding. Notes. Copy. Cap it at. Don't want to copy that. Check in with the chat. I'm a night owl. Dude, yeah, you are. What is it, 5 hours later? It's 8:30 Eastern. What does that mean? 8, right? 9, 10, 11, 12, 1. What do you do for work, man, that allows you to be a night owl? Andrew says, Mike, you inspire me every day. For real? That's freaking awesome. You inspire me every day writing in from Montreal, Canada. But I've got friends here with me from each corner of the country. We love you up here. Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's freaking awesome, man. It's cool that I do get a decent amount of traction in like Canada and England, just from like whatever the YouTube analytics tell me, which is cool. You guys gonna give me some more Canadians besides Cohen? But I do have so many more Leonard Cohen songs to do. So many good Cohen songs. Well, Andrew, awesome. Nice to meet you. Quentin, awesome. Nice to meet you as well. I've got a buddy in London. I've never made it to Montreal. French Canadian sounds. It looks gorgeous up there. I've been to Toronto and Vancouver, but never ventured further north than right at the border. Can I even get into Canada? I know it was all Kofufu crazy, but I think I can go to Canada now. Have you ever played live? Do you have? Yeah, I used to play. I lived in Austin, Texas for like 6 years, and we would gig there. Malaro for Illinois would. Go check out Malaro for Illinois at Bandcamp or your favorite streaming services, and you can check out some of my original stuff. Or, you know, those Song of Day Septembers. Yeah, I used to gig. I've only really briefly made a living doing it, and that was when I was in this band called The Queensmen. If you're into 60s rock, this was our attempt at, like, British Invasion rock and roll, all original songs, but we try to do it in the fashion of like pre-70s rock, 60s British Invasion rock, so Beatles and Kinks, and that was a really fun record. So we would do weddings and events and that kind of, we got paid doing that, but when I would gig with my band, no, we'd have like 2 gigs a month and go home with like $150 total. Especially in Austin, it's hard to make a living. Could you do a lesson for some Dave Van Ronk? Maybe Samson and Delilah or Come Back Baby would be nice. Cheers, man. Yeah, DL, I've only done a couple of Van Ronks. Mac the Knife, and I think I did one other tutorial, maybe. He's kind of a bit screamy for me, but when I learned Mac the Knife, I was blown away. It's really beautiful picking. It's a great melody and really... He does some kind of cool, novel ideas in that song. So I'll check out these other ones. If I don't, please remind me. What happens if I star it? I don't even know what that means. Just email me at mikesmusicmethod@gmail.com. And then when I'm not focusing on other things, I'll go listen to those songs. Would you ever consider making a video on tips for playing live for someone just getting into it? I'm considering going to an open mic night soon. Yeah. Yeah. Well, let's do the video right now. Because I think that Town Songs repeats a lot. I don't know Patrick's... I mean, no, someone might have said something about Patrick Sky the other day. What if I make a new tab? Is it still sharing the other one? We could look up Patrick Sky together. Here, this will save. We can come back to it. And then we can talk about open mics. We can all give Rise Up some tips. Well, I don't know. Give me a song by this guy. He's gotten, like, no views on YouTube. Is he just, like, your buddy? Oh, is this older stuff? Oh, see, I did click on this one. Was someone telling us about Patrick Sky last week? Is he another Canadian? Oh, it's muted. Is he singing? Words Without Music, but doesn't... that's funny. Haha, get it? It's an instrumental song called Words Without Music. He's funny, Patrick. You're funny.
Mm-hmm.
That's real pretty. It sounds a lot like early Dylan.
I've damn near walked this world around, another city, another town, another friend to say goodbye.
This is really pretty. I should do like reaction videos. Voice. It's so beautiful. He sounds like an angel. I've never heard anything like it.
Another girl.
Did you hear how he said girl right there? Girl.
To sit and cry. And it's many a mile.
Many a mile.
I've spent on this road. It's many.
No, I'm being a jerk, but this is a beautiful song. Thanks for sharing this. Yeah, I did a Jackson C. Frank song. I forget what the name of it. Which is a cool tune. I got a ton of requests for that song. I can't say I really like the guy, though, to be honest.
A mile I have gone.
Yeah, this is rad, man. What's this guy's story? You'll have to tell me a bit about him. DL. Cool. Open mic, rise up. Well, just over-rehearse. That's my number one tip, is over-rehearse. Don't practice a whole bunch of different songs. Like, learn four songs real, real, real well and over-rehearse them. And then before you go perform them live, like, play in different areas of your house. Play in different chairs and on a bench. And then take your guitar to, like, a friend's house and play there. If you can sit somewhere outside and play, like in a park, do that. And just kind of the more you like move around and play in different environments, because if you're always like sitting in front of your computer and you're never practicing somewhere else, it's quite a different experience when there's a crowd and you're also in like a novel environment. And practice in like super bright lighting and then practice in real dark lighting, because sometimes stage lighting can really screw with you, because it can kind of blind you. Or it can just be like a real dimly lit bar and then like you don't have enough light. Those are my tips. You know, in terms of nerves, you just kind of got to ride through it. Man, I don't have any tips for that. I've heard real dumb stuff about like eat a banana. What? Those are my tips. Over rehearse. Record yourself a bunch and listen back. That's super important. And just do the same songs. Just get four real good. Oh, yeah, that's a great one too, Jackie. Go to the open mic the week before you're going to play. It helps to get the vibe of the bar without pressure. That's great advice, actually. Go to the open mic and actually meet some people. That's real good advice. Yeah, it's a fun way. That's what I did, right? The first time I moved to Pittsburgh, I did some open mics here. And that was a cool way to meet people. And yeah, but it's been a while. I'm a homebody. I'm a homebody. In another life, I want to be like a cattle rancher and a homesteader or something. Because I don't need to go out. I did that. I'm over it. I have no desire to go out. I don't even go see live music. People always ask, oh, you're a musician. You have good taste. You should. What do you go see live? I don't go see live music. COVID didn't help because no one would have me at their venues. All right. Any other questions, thoughts? Many a mile. Should we keep going with towns? Let's do it. We've already come so far. Patrick Sky. This is cool, though. I like Patrick Sky. Thanks again, DL. Down low, Malaro. Let's open it back up. Hit share the flat. How did I do it? Like this? But it's sharing the wrong one now. Present. Stop share. Present. Share screen. There's too many buttons in this app. How does that look? Does that work? I've been there plenty of times. It'll probably go introduce myself to the group before I go to play. Thanks for the tips. Yeah, good luck, man. What songs are you going to do? Let us know what songs you're going to do. Why don't you jump on here and perform? Hey, that'll be good practice. I know there's a way I can, like, invite people on. Can I invite you? How do I do this? What does it mean? Send this link to your guests. Hey, I'm putting you on the spot. Rise up. All right. I'm sending you the StreamYard invite. Get your guitar. You're going to perform for us tonight. All right. It's on. Let's do this. You got 5 minutes to get your guitar and tune up.
Why is it? Again, reach home on tomorrow. Never.
Same chords, he just sings higher.
Thunder again. I'm weak and I'm weary with sorrow.
Yeah, so the verse just repeated twice. So this repeats here. Never.
London to Dublin, Australia to Perth. London.
Oh, man, I can't even hear the guitar in this version.
London. To Dublin, Australia. London to Dublin, Australia.
I have no idea what exactly he's doing because his vocals are so loud. Where is the open mic? Where are you located, Rise Up? What town? I like going back to the one better.
Australia to Perth, London to Dublin, Australia to Perth.
Some kind of G chord.
I gaze at your skies and I taste it. To Dublin, Australia to Perth.
Back to the A minor. Boom, goon, gain, and goon. Is that A minor? I changed it.
Dublin, Australia to Perth.
Skies. F.
I gaze at your skies and I tasted your earth.
I gaze at your skies and I tasted your earth.
Your skies and I tasted. I gaze at your skies and I tasted.
It's impossible to hear the guitar. It's just too quiet. But it's two D minors and then an F. pattern really works. Geese that just got. Oops.
That your skies are tasted at your earth.
Changes, there's some kind of note there. All right, I sent you the invite. Where are you? Where are you, Rise Up? Come on and perform for us. It's been 5 minutes, man.
I sung out my heart.
Guys, I really don't like doing this late town stuff. This playing's just so freaking sloppy and unimpressive. What are you doing, towns? Lifts up the chord there because he was too drunk.
I sung out my heart for what?
An F, but now we got the low F in there. And C, G slash B, A minor.
I got my heart for what it was worth.
Just kind of that's tied. Boo-dun-dun. Back to the A minor.
Hard for what it was worth.
There's another note there. Something like that. Boom, dun, boom. Enough to repeat. Maybe there was something different in there, but
it was worth never again. Love.
G with a D.
Never again. Will
Oh, towns. Hold on. All right, let me catch up. SD, sloppy towns. I know, sloppy Joe, man. He's drunk and sloppy. I don't like listening to these later versions. Some songs from Acoustic Blue is a clearly influenced from Lightnin' Hopkins. It isn't easy to catch all of what he's doing. Tons of his stuff, for sure, inspired by Lightning. Yeah, it's just the vocals are mixed so darn loud, and the guitar is just kind of trailing off. I'll put on headphones later and, like, touch this up. How long are you going to be live for? Probably won't be back home for another... I'm not going to be live for 2 more hours. Rise up. Yeah, and if anyone ever wants to jump on and just shoot the breeze, I can throw people on for a few minutes, and I'd love to get to meet y'all. So I'd be down with that. I appreciate the super chat earlier, Rise Up. Thank you, man. Just got to grab a bottle and get on his level. Don't do it. Drinking's for dopes. You know, it's fun for a while until it isn't. And then you look back and you go, well, that was stupid and pointless and risky for no apparent gain. So don't do that. All right, good. I lie. I barely ever drink anymore. Good. That's the answer I wanted to hear, Rise Up. Glory to God, man.
Again, will I ramble?
Ugh, come on. That sounds awful. Hey, what's he doing? It's like he forgot the chord and then really quickly went to a G7. Freaking ramblings of a drunk man. Boom, gong, 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 gong. One and two. That I missed. Gung, 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 gung. Then he totally loses the rhythm. Getting there, right? So we have a hammer on. I'll get this rambling, this drunken rambling exact. And then it's open. So when I really can't hear it, I slow it down. Alright, it's not an incoherent riff. I take it back, but the execution is really sloppy. It's Towns. It's okay. We love them. Appreciate the videos. Thank you, Eugene. I appreciate you, man. Glad to see you all stopping in and saying yo. Maxwell says, hey, Mike, I just want to say that you've got the best TVZ tutorials on the internet. Yeah, I'm learning Columbine now, live from Canada. Love from Canada. Yeah, Maxwell, thank you, man. I love these comments. They're super encouraging. because I spend a ton of time doing this stuff, I feel like I'm a pretty good teacher. And it's really exciting that I'm actually, I feel like I'm doing the best out there too. You know, not to toot my own horn, but I don't think there's anyone even coming close to doing these town songs as accurate as I am. And John Hurt as well. I mean, maybe there's someone out there, but I haven't come across him. There could be, you know, other small channels, but... And I pride myself. I'm giving you this stuff for free, which means you guys should seriously consider donating. I would love to make this my day job, and I'd be able to get to so many more songs and put so much more time into it. So even if that's like 10 bucks a month for you, if you can offer 40 bucks a month, 20 bucks a month, 5 bucks a month, it goes a long way, guys. Even if I could get, you know, a tenth of all my subscribers to give 5 bucks a month, boom, that could be my full-time gig. You know, 1,000 people giving 5 bucks a month for nonstop Towns Van Zandt and Mississippi John Hurt and John Prine. Like, I could do their entire catalogs if you guys buy me the time. That would be an amazing, you know, thing to do for humanity and the folk music movement. Free lessons on all this stuff. It's amazing. So thanks, Maxwell, for the comment and encouragement. Santana says, don't you think he gets in and out of time on purpose? No. No. On this song, no. He's gone. I mean, sure, there's some like lag you can have, but you can just tell his like pick hand, like he actually, like he's missing, and it's like too thick and heavy sounding, and that's not on purpose. He just doesn't have his faculties. Rise up. At least for me, I found 90% of my substance use, mostly booze and bud, was rooted in escapism. Escaping myself, reality, and my emotions. Escaping no longer satisfies me. That, yeah. Mine was in that too, I would say. That sounds about right. Yeah, there's some element of like, oh, I'm just having fun, but yeah, well, why can't you have fun without the booze? So what's really behind that fun? Yeah, escapism. Coping with the insanity that is reality. Reality's crazy. Life is crazy. What the hell's going on? What are these things? What am I? What's happening here? It's a trip, so it's no wonder a lot of people drink. But I'm glad it's to a minimum. Rise up. Keep it that way. SD says, I'm starting to appreciate the amount of time you put into transcribing songs for your videos. Oh, Rhino. Thank you, sweetie. But come on, starting to appreciate it? Nah, don't lie. You've known, right? Didn't you know? Didn't you know how hard this was? How hard this is? Jackie says, you definitely helped expose me to towns. Yeah, I found him on YouTube. I wish I had a cooler town story. But I've said before, it was just that Heartworn Highways videos of the sobbing grown black man. I'd rather be creative instead of getting loaded, so thanks for helping with that. Dun, 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 dun. Does it really help? That's amazing. If that's like an amazing compliment, if you really mean that, if this channel is helping you to create and play guitar instead of boozing, freaking A, man, then I'm doing something worthwhile and noble with the channel. So thanks, Rise Up. Yeah, crazy indeed. Crazy indeed. I agree with you. Cool. Is that the song? You guys tell me. Rise up, let me know. Does the song keep looping? Or is there another part? Because I feel like that takes us through the verse and the chorus, you know what I mean? Whatever, it's not like I can monetize this channel now. I've been playing like the entire song. So we can keep listening.
There's nowhere left.
Well, whatever, that's enough for now. I don't want to keep going with this right now. Anything else? It's been an hour. Should we keep hanging out? Is anyone going to join in? Anyone want to join? I can send you invites. Who else is still hanging out? Let's post this super chat. Let's post this. Look at that, $4.99 super chat. What are you other schlums doing, huh? There's 12 people hanging out. Come on, tip the guitar man. A tip for the guitar man. Entertaining you. I mean, I'll hang up. You guys could go watch another stupid Netflix show where they try to force booze and drinking and homosexuality in the agenda. Why does every Netflix show involve, you know, sex, homosexual sex, drugs, you know, someone's a secret alcoholic or drug user, or it's just like, I don't watch it. My wife knits a lot, and that's her perfect excuse for watching Netflix. It's a solid excuse. She's making awesome hats and stuff for our kids, but it's like every show's got, it's the same. Even if the plot's different, they still got to add the same little, got to be cool and hip with the times, I guess. I think it just keeps looping. I think we can figure out the rest. Yeah, and I'll do a proper tutorial on it. I'll put headphones on and get it a little cleaner. Rob says, thanks for doing these, Mike. I haven't tried to learn a new song in a while, but your tutorials are the best. Thanks, Rob. Thank you. Yeah, well, you should try to learn a new one. I wish I could, click on you guys and see, you know, so I know some of you have, like, channels and stuff up, but I can't do that on StreamYard because I'm not on YouTube right now, so I don't know how to do that. What else, y'all? What else? So, big news, Strum It Like a Cowboy, my first interactive ebook is, the first draft is done. It's 42 pages long, single-spaced, and it's all about strumming. It takes you through, let me hide this comment so you guys can see me better. It takes you through everything you need to know about strumming, you know, downs, down and ups. Then you have like the misses in there, down, down, miss up, down, up. Then you've got like muted strums. It talks about pick strum, goes into bass runs, and I'm super excited about this interactive ebook. And the whole idea behind it, or philosophy behind it, is that these tutorials are great, but it's hard to, like, no one sits with a video like you sit with a book, right? Maybe you'll spend a couple weeks on it, a month tops. But a book is cool because you have it there and you can revisit it, and you're putting more and more time into it, and you're running through different, you know, you can make your own notes in the book, and it's, the whole thing is like, teaches you how to do this stuff, but then gives you like practice routines at the end of each section. And so it's a total novel idea here at Mike's Music Method that I'm trying, but I'm super excited about it. When I started writing it, I was like, yeah, this is going to be cool. But the more I write it, I'm just like, heck yeah, this is a freaking awesome ebook. And my wife's sick of me talking about the ebook. So she'll be formatting it soon. And when I sent out my mailer, I had two responses were with like copy editors and journalists who are going to look it over for me. So that was a cool little, you know, a nice thing that they're going to do for free. So thank you, Luke. And thank you, Steve, if you're listening. And I'm excited about it. And you guys should be excited about it too. Jackie, yes, I am on Venmo. Let's do that. That's way better. SD, aw, gratitude. Dude, it is the week of gratitude. Let's pin that. Everyone say three things you're grateful for. That's a very important prayer. Don't overlook that prayer. First thing you do when you wake up, even if you feel like crap, you got to say a couple things you're grateful for. Do it before you have dinner and do it at bedtime. That's my Mike's Music Method advice. I am on Venmo. Let me give it to you. Thank you, Rhino. Mike Malaro Music. I don't like often promote that because, I don't know, in Venmo's terms and services, it's very clear. Like, these people should be your friends. It should not be transactions, but it's fine. Not many people are using it, so you definitely can. What did I miss here? Rise up. And yeah, your channel definitely helped. I wouldn't be anywhere near where I'm at with guitar without your channel. That's been my main outlet for the past year. Heck yeah. That's awesome, man. Can I ask how old you are? I'm always curious. Like, are people just like picking it up as hobbyists, or are you young enough where you actually might like do something with it? Not that being 50 years old and playing doesn't mean you're not doing something with it, but you know what I mean? Like, professional aspirations, I guess is what I'm saying. Yeah, rise up. I'll let you know when the ebook is out. Books are way too underrated nowadays. Yep. Wait, how do I... Yes, I'm on Venmo. Book sounds awesome. Thanks, Rob. Is there e-transfer? in the States. What? Funds? You mean funds? You guys PayPal? Is e-transfer an actual app? You know what? I have Revolut because I was teaching someone in Norway. I don't know exactly what you mean by e-transfer. No, I think that's just a Canadian thing. We have like wire transfers, but you can use PayPal or Venmo or Revolut. I don't know how to say that one. Oh, and there's Zelle. We use Zelle in the States. That's like the banking one. Gardener, what's happening? I haven't seen you in a minute. Yeah, underneath the descriptions in all my videos, there's all the links to PayPal and Patreon. And what else? You can write me a check. I have a P.O. box, guys. You can write me a check and then I'll send you a Christmas card. How about that? That's the best way to do it. Let me find my P.O. box number. Mike's Music Method. I have to search myself to find my own P.O. box number. 152 Wildwood. I don't remember it. Darn it. Come on now. Bear with me. I'm finding my P.O. box number. Found it. Just write me a letter, guys, even if you don't have any money to give me. My P.O. box has been empty. Oh, I wanted to read a letter. Let me read a letter. That's what I wanted to do. I did get a letter. I got one letter in my P.O. box. Let me read it to you guys. I'm super excited. Shelly, if you listen to this, this is awesome. Shelly wrote me a letter. Shelly in Michigan. Look at this. She sent me a card. Look at these cute little birds. You don't know how excited I was to go to my P.O. box and get this. And she gave me like $95 too. Unbelievable. So generous of you, Shelly. Thank you. She hand wrote this. The Lord your God is with you. He is mighty to save. I can't read it. Handwriting. He is mighty to save. He will take great delight in you, quiet you with his love. He will rejoice over you with singing. That is beautiful. And then, dear Mike, may the beauty of nature fill your heart with peace and joy throughout the year. So happy for your help on buckets of rain. LOL, Shelley. Unbelievable, isn't that so nice? Thanks, Shelley. I'm very pleased with my P.O. box. And Shelly, you'll be getting a Malaro family Christmas card this year. I need a special place for these. I need like a filing cabinet. I'm gonna forget and lose that, Shelly. I'm sorry if you don't get a Christmas card. No. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna figure it out. I'm gonna hold myself accountable. All right, guys. I think I'm gonna finish editing America. I've been working on Paul Simon's America, which was requested by somebody. Hannah P. Rise Up says, I am 25, definitely want to start writing at some point. I feel like music can actually make a difference in people's lives and impact people on a soul level that would make me more content than any job. Heck yeah, man. It's for real. I'm doing it now. The YouTube journey has been amazing. But even before that, I would just teach private lessons. And I have, you know, over 30 students that I'm teaching every week. And yeah, for some of these kids, I became like a mentor, and it was just really amazing relationships. And the way I explain it, and the way I think it works for a lot of people, I mean, it works in different ways for everybody. But one thing music can definitely do is give people a certain sense of like real autonomy and creativity. And I'm convinced if you actually really feel that in one area of your life, then that's all that matters. Like if you can touch it in one aspect of your life, then not that you're super confident in all these other areas in your life, but because you've touched it in one area, it just like transforms you. It gives you a certain sense of like value and meaning and confidence. And so I think if you can get a kid good enough where they've kind of experienced that, it's just, yeah, enriching beyond belief. Yeah, on a spiritual level and certainly a psychological level as well. So do it, Rise Up, do it. I would love to, dude, if no joke, if you're interested in teaching and songwriting, I'd be happy to give you a half an hour lesson once a week on the house. Mike's Music Method mentorship program. So happy to do that, Rise Up. If you're serious about it and if you have the time to like take it seriously, then I'd be more than happy to do that. Just send me an email. From now, I'm just learning songs from artists that I'm inspired by musically. Maybe someone will rub off eventually. Yeah, just keep learning a bunch of songs and always try to mimic. Like every time I learn a song, I create a study piece. And that doesn't mean you have to write it down and finish it. But like, for example, if I was like learning a, I don't know, let me just pull up a John Hurt tab, for example. Stacko Lee by John Hurt. I'll show you what I mean. So the first measure is, I'm horribly out of tune. What happened? So the first one's a... So then it's just like, all right, I got that one little riff from John Hurt, but can I like move it around to different chords? So I'm doing the same kind of picking pattern, the same hammer-on idea, but on different frets and different string sets and on different chords. And that like really solidifies what you've just learned, but it's also like now you own it, right? Like you can take that little piece and create your own cool melodies off of that pattern. To me is super invaluable. So that's one way to like get into songwriting is just mimicry. Right? You want to mimic the greats. Good night, Maxwell. Thank you. Mike, you're a beauty. Oh, look at that. Look at this. Look at this comment here. What a sweetheart. All right. I'm going to go talk to my wife and I might relax in the tub with a book. I'm supposed to be Bible studying with a buddy of mine at church and he wants to read through Job. So I might go read some Job in the tub. Or finish America. Options. I've got options. But they're all better than Netflix. Get off your screens. Create, right? Create, don't consume. That's a good goal for 2023, isn't it? Be a creator, not a consumer. Thanks for the video. Yeah, Jackie, of course. Jackie Instrumental. It sounds nice, Jackie Instrumental. Is that like a popular channel that you have over there? I don't want to get rid of Patrick Sky. Can I like search people on here? You think I'd know how to use YouTube by now. Jackie Instrumental. You're playing some guitar on here. Look at you, man. Hey, this is nice. Hey, dude, Jackie, this is killer, man. I'm going to freaking put you on. We're going to play your songs right now, dude. How come you didn't tell us, Jackie? Hiding your talents from the world. All right, let's get Jackie some views. Okay, guys, come on here. I'll link Jackie. Here's Jackie doing yesterday. Which one should we play for the people, Jackie? All right, go. Everyone go subscribe. There's too many freaking buttons. I'm sorry, guys. I don't want to present that anymore. I want to present something else. I want to present this. I want to present Jackie's song. Last Christmas. You got it. Let's do that one. I'll find it. All right, let's watch. That's me singing, not Jackie. Subscribe. Let's like it. Oh yeah. Dude. Cool. I love it. Did I share it? Was I able to share it? I think did I share it, guys, or no? I think I did. That was sweet. That was really pretty. Good playing. Nice tone. I like the sweater is awesome, and what do you have? Is that one of those carbon fiber acoustics that you're playing? What is that thing? I like the telly. Right? Is that a telly and something else? Ooh, Hallelujah instrumental cover. Ooh, Lost Boy. You're playing some keys, some Ruth B. Dude, that Ruth B girl. I actually love her voice. She has this song called Mixed Signals, and it's freaking great. I mean, her music in general is stupid. It's like she should just write her own songs. But, you know, she's a little trying to be pop star, but her voice is fantastic. Yeah, you're welcome for the shout out. That was cool. What up, Connor? We're about to call it a night, dude, but you jumped in. You jumped in late. You missed a good hangout. Dude, there's more and more people jumping on. What, all you freaking night owls. Mikhail says, you've got a great face, Mike. It must be said. Aw. Thanks. You missed it earlier. I was showing everyone my teeth. They're yellow instead of white. Look at this face. Look at this great face. Look at it. Look at this. My skin's pink. No, it's just the light reflecting off it. Look at these red eyes. I don't have like those crazy people with those like amazingly white. The whites of their eyes are like pure white. Mine are not pure white. I'm an old man. Thank you, though, Mikhail. It's very thoughtful of you. It's an Ibanez thin line acoustic. Really smooth feel. I can't say I like solid gold teeth. That's right. Matthew, hey, Mike. Really appreciate the videos. Learn Lewis Collins and Clay Pigeons from you. Yeah, working on Richland Woman Blues now. That one's hard. That one is hard. But, dude, this is awesome. It's so cool to do this live stream and you know, meet a lot of you that are actually tangibly learning real concrete things and skills from the channel. It's just very exciting and encouraging. What do I have in my pocket? This is life with kids. You're sitting on things. You've had beads in your pocket. When did the kid put this in my pocket? I don't know. Got beads in my pocket, though. Eden posted a Poncho and Lefty cover on my Instagram. I'd love some feedback. Ooh, on your Insta. Let's do it. Insta. I don't know how to use this thing anymore. I never want to be on Instagram. I deleted it from my phone. I suggest you all do the same. You can use it from your computer, but delete it from your frickin' phone. Is it the most recent one? Let's see, is this it? How do I play the sound? All right, let's do it. You want some feedback? You're getting it. You're getting it. Okay. There's got to be a shortcut to share this screen. There's too many buttons. Okay, here we go. Oh, let's look at this picture. Freaking Oregon. That's amazing. Where is this? Shout out, God. I know. Holy Christ. How does he do it? That is unbelievable, man. Glory to God. Glory to God. All right. It's a little crackly.
Living on the road, my friend, it's gonna keep you free and clean. Now you wear your skin like iron, your breath's as hard as kerosene. Weren't your mama's only boy, favorite one it seems. Began to cry as you said goodbye. Pancho was a bandit, boys. A horse was faster than polished steel. Wore his gun outside his pants for all the honest world to feel. But Pancho met his match, you know. Deserts down in Mexico. Nobody heard his dying word. That's the way it goes. All the federales say, good ahead of many day. Only let them slip away. The kindness, I suppose. Lefty, he can't sing the blues all night long like he used to. Thus the poncho bit down south, yet ended up and left his mouth. One day they laid poor Poncho low, left his split for Ohio, where he got the bread to go. Ain't nobody know. And all the federales say, could have had them any day. Only let them slip away. The kindness, I suppose. Well, the poets tell how Pancho fell. Lefty's living in a cheap hotel. Well, Cleveland's pine, Cleveland's cold. So the story ends, we're told. Well, Pancho needs your prayers, it's true. Save a few for Lefty too. He just did what he had to do. Now he's growing old. All the federales say, could have had them any day. Only let them slip away. The kindness, I suppose. A few gray federales say, could have had them any day. Only let them slip away. Kindness, I suppose.
Yeah. Dude, I love this stuff. It's so cool that you guys are learning from the channel and doing this. Thanks for sharing, Connor. I really appreciate it, man. Connor's become a buddy of mine, man, just from the channel. Yeah. Getting some feedback here. Oh, yeah. Rhino says, nice, bro. Rizep says, nice guild. I play a guild also. I did for a long time too. A buddy like loaned me one for years and the thing was great. This makes me so happy. I'm happy. But me and Connor have become buddies. We call each other up every once in a while now. You know, thanks to the internet. And yeah. Frickin' A. Now I'm happy. Who else wants to share something? Come on, it's open mic. It doesn't even have to be live open mic. What else? Come on, who's got something to share? What else you got on your channel, Jackie? You do any originals? Dude, we got to get Jackie more views. Folsom Prison Blues. Well, I guess your first one was only 5 months ago, huh? You're just getting started. Dude, my advice, Jackie, is just like keep doing it. Like when I first started doing it, my early videos got no traction at all. So just keep doing it. These are cool little videos. And, you know, you'll eventually find your shtick, you know, you like see what you like doing and what you don't like doing, and you never know when something's gonna catch. Hey, you got a little hallelujah. Da na 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 na. Yeah, just covers for now. Covers are fine. Keep doing covers. But, yeah, if you want to write, you should write too. Don't let anybody stop you. Gardner, thanks for the Coulter Wall content, Mike. Yeah, I'm overdue for another Coulter song. Which one should I do? Gardner, tell us. Thanks for the advice. You're very welcome. I hope it's good advice. It's advice. Is it good? I don't know. I don't know. Renegade is my favorite. Renegade what is your favorite? Your favorite cover that you have up? Oh, yeah, you do have that. Let's share one more while Gardner lets us know. Oh yeah, I know this song. Now I get to be in the screen with Jackie. Jackie, you get your first reaction video. I'm jealous. No one's done a reaction video of me yet. Look at how many of this guy there are. Holy cow. What's he hitting there? What's that thing with the bells on it? Look at these watches. Look at this, a man of many watches. Or is it the same watch just because it's many pictures of the same man? Keys, it has like a nice pad element to it, makes it like dreamier and cool. I was about to complain that the thing was like a little too dry, but the pad kind of gives it some spaciousness and emotion. It needs horses running in a field visual. It does. What up, Extra Cheese Project? Oh yeah, look at that arpeggio, holy cow, holy moly, that arpeggio. Welcome, Jackie. Freaking A. It's cool. Yeah, wait, let me click out of here. Yeah, Connor, dude, so you got, like, the emotion that you're hitting with it is fantastic. I love the, like, kind of raw approach of it. It's really hard for me to like do that. The more you play, it's harder to like get in touch with that. So that's what's cool about it. Yeah, and singing, we talked about it. Just like do a whole, just start singing along with stuff on YouTube, like silly vocal warm-ups. It'll help improve your pitch. And so you get embarrassed even doing it alone. I can't say I get embarrassed doing it alone. Definitely in front of other people, but no, that is a problem. You should maybe get help for that, dude. Was anyone else get embarrassed singing by yourself alone? I take that back. I was fortunately, when I was like, I wasn't, you know, I was never tone deaf, but I couldn't match pitch. But fortunately, I was young enough where I wasn't like totally self-aware of how bad I was as I was getting better. So I lucked out in that regard, I think. Yeah, what up, cheese? Howdy, howdy. Howdy, howdy, extra cheese. Oh, sorry, Gardner. Yeah, I've gotten many requests for Coding Dream, so I should do that. And Snake Mountain Blues. Let me throw those both on the list right now. And then I'm done. Now I'm getting tired. And I've got some Bible reading and praying to do. Sorry, no, never mind. Give me one second. Coding Dream. I'm sure this is probably already on my tutorial playlist. Add to playlist. Songs to tutorial. And then what's the other one? Snake some. Oh, you mean the town song? A cover of a cover? How does this one sound again?
Drink your green liquor, Lord, you roll to the ground.
Yeah, I mean, Coding Dream I prefer, but this song's cool too. I'll add it to the list. This one I'm not going to promise I'll get to right now, but I can do Coding Dream for shiz. For shiz, best place to learn to sing is in the car. I'm going to have to agree with Rise Up on that one. Probably the car. All right, guys, this was awesome. This was fun. These Sunday ones are fun, but I'll probably be on again tomorrow as well. Let's say 8 on the ish, 8-ish tomorrow. And then we'll either do more, I don't know, we'll just do whatever we do. We'll learn more towns, or maybe we'll write a song together like we did last Sunday, 2 Sundays ago. All right, again, this is so much fun. Thanks for showing your support and appreciation, guys. Rise Up, thanks for the super chat. And Connor, Extra Cheese, Gardner, Jackie, be well. Peace. Be in touch, guys. No joke. If anyone ever wants to chat, shoot me an email. Hit me up. Rob F., whoever's still around. All right. Nighty night, everybody. Oh, yeah. You're welcome, Jackie. Mm-hmm. You're very welcome. Take care, Mike. I'll definitely email when my life calms down a bit. Yep. All right. Good luck, man. Take care of yourself, okay? Peace, guys. God bless you all. Be well. Do good. God is good. See you guys soon. Ciao.